Hello student, welcome to the KTHM e-learning portal. I am Pratik Shinde, working as assistant professor in Department of Zoology, KTHM College, Nashik. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the chapter apiculture and we are going to discuss the topic, the colony organization and division of labor seen in honeybee. First, we see the introduction of the colony organization and division of labor. We all are social beings. We live in a society and work for a society. Similar are the bees, a social insect. Like us, each individual in a bee colony has to work for the welfare of other and colony, which we term as division of labor. A bee colony consists of different type of caste or individuals who cooperate in collecting food, taking care of young ones and the production of honey. A normal bee colony has three castes. First is queen bee, second is worker bee, and third is the drone bees. You may recognize them by their morphological and developmental differences. In a normal colony, there are one queen and it is an functional and fertile female. Then there are 2000 to 70,000 workers called sterile females and 100 to 500 drones called male bees. These are the three castes seen in honeybee colony. See the morphological differences between these three honeybees. First is worker bee, queen bee, and drone bee. The queen bee is the largest bee among these three castes. Then the drone bee is an second largest bee present in a bee colony. And the worker bee is an smallest bee seen in honeybee colony. Then we discuss one by one these three castes. First we discuss the queen bee. Each colony has a single queen irrespective of the colony size. The queen bee is larger than the worker bee and drone bee, has a black, golden, brown and gray shiny cylindrical abdomen and longer body, a round and comparatively small head. She is the only perfect developed queen and it is mother of colony. Queen provides the cohesive force which keep the thousands of worker members of the colony together as a social unit using a queen substance. Her primary function is to reproduce, that is egg laying. The virgin queen mate with many drones. This is known as nuptial flight or marriage flight. She produces both fertilized and unfertilized egg. From the fertilized egg, queen and worker will produce. And from unfertilized egg, only drones be produced. During the peak of production, queen may lay up to 1,500 to 2,000 eggs per day. One queen may produce up to 250,000 eggs per year and the possible more than 10 lakh in her life. The second major function of the queen bee is secreting pheromone known as queen substance. The queen substance, also termed the queen retained pheromone, Q क्यूआरपी, क्यूआरपी इज एन एट कॉम्पोनेंट फेरोमोन. द मेन कॉम्पोनेंट इज 9-oxo-2-deaconic एसिड. द फंक्शन ऑफ क्वीन सब्सटेंस अट्रैक्टिंग वर्कर्स टू द क्वीन. एंड द प्राइमरी फंक्शन इज टू फिजियोलॉजिकल इनहिबिशन ऑफ वर्कर ओवरी डेवलपमेंट. दैट्स वी कॉल्ड एज वर्कर बी आर स्टराइल फीमेल. इट ऑल्सो एक्ट एज अ सेक्स फेरोमोन अट्रैक्टिंग ड्रोन ड्यूरिंग मेटिंग फ्लाइट. Sting apparatus is converted into ovipositor and used for egg laying. The average productive life span of queen is 2 to 5 years. Then the second caste is drone bee. Drones are the male bees, are the larger than worker bee and smaller than queen bee, with the blunted abdomen at the end and are blackish and hairy. They do not have sting. A colony will usually have a few hundred drones. They develop from unfertilized egg and complete their life cycle in 24 days. They lead a life of rest during no work while being fed by workers. Their only purpose is to mate with a new virgin queen and also useful to reduce the temperature of the colony by wing beating. They die after mating or are removed from the hive in winter when breeding is ceased. The maximum life of drone in summer is 59 days. This is a photograph of drone bee. The third caste is worker bee. The worker are sterile females because the queen substance inhibit the development of ovaries of worker bee, and it is developed from fertilized egg. Worker are smaller than drone and have yellowish dark brown or gray abdominal strips according to the bee species. The number of worker bee in different species like Apis mellifera, 60,000 to 70,000 worker bee seen in Apis mellifera colony, and in case of Serena, 25,000 to 30,000 workers seen in Apis serena colony. A worker has an average life of only 40 to 50 days during honey flow season or spring and summer season, and her life may extend up to 6 months during off season or winter season. We already discussed the queen substance is inhibit the development of ovaries in worker bee. They can't egg laying, but in absence of queen they may egg lay. Under the queenless condition for a long duration, ovaries of some of the worker start developing and they can lay even egg, but since these are unfertilized, give rise to only drones. Then we see the division of labor seen in worker bee. The entire colony survive on the service of worker bee. They feed all the members of the colony. such as queen, drone, and larva. If they fail to function, the entire colony will die. The division of labor among the worker is on physiological basis. They have specialized structure such as hypopharyngeal gland, scent gland, wax gland, pollen basket, which allow them to perform all the activities of the hive. All the activities in a honeybee colony are performed by worker bee, including honey and pollen collection, brood rearing, building comb, feeding the drone and queen, cleaning the hive, and defencing the colony. The specific activity are defined by the age of the worker bee. For example, the first 3-day old worker perform a cleaning duty. Then we see the duties of worker bee, or also called as the division of labor. The duties of worker bee divided into two groups. First is field workers and outdoor workers, and the second group is house bees and indoor workers. Those bees work in a field or outdoor, they called as outdoor workers, and those bees work in the hive are called as indoor worker or house bee. In the field workers, there are again two groups, searcher bee and forager bee. Those bee participate in searching of water, nectar, pollen sources. These categorize under the searcher bee and called as water searcher, nectar searcher and pollen searcher. Then the forager bee. Forager bee, those bee collect water, nectar and pollen from the field, they called as forager bees. And they categorize such as water forager, nectar forager and pollen forager. When we talk about and house bee, they again categorize into the different groups according to their duties, such as cleaner bee, clean the hive, nurse bee, rearing or take caring of brood, then builder bee, build the comb, guard bee, defending the colony, fanner bee, reduce the temperature of colony or hive, and receiver bee, receive the water, nectar and pollen from forager bees. These are the different duties of worker bee, or also called as the division of labor seen in worker bee. In the outdoor workers, we see the searcher bee. Searcher bee, those bee search pollen, nectar and water sources and inform to the other bees performing a various dances. They categories into the two groups, water searcher and nectar and pollen searcher. And these bee perform these work when they 21 to 22 day old. Honeybee having chewing and lapping type of mouth part. When they collect nectar and water, they have specialized tongue, and this tongue called as proboscis. It is used for injecting nectar and water. See here, this is an proboscis. Collection for use for collection of nectar and collection of water. Then also they have specialized stomach for storing nectar collected from flowers. are waters, so they have can carry it back to the hive. Then the pollen forager having specialized structure called pollen basket present on metathoracic leg. See here, this is an pollen basket present on metathoracic leg. They collect pollen and can carry it back to their hive. Here you can see the morphological differences seen in worker bees. See here, this is an pollen basket. Collect the pollen from flowers, and this is an proboscis, collection of nectar and water. Pollen basket present on metathoracic leg of honeybee. See here, this is an prothoracic leg, mesothoracic leg and metathoracic leg. And the honeybee having chewing and lapping type of mouth part and tongue called as proboscis. It is used for injecting nectar and water. Then the indoor workers. In indoor worker, first is cleaner's bee. The cleaner's bee remove dead and waste material from hive. Cleaner bee having pollen brush present on prothoracic and mesothoracic leg. See here, this is an pollen brush present on prothorax, prothoracic leg and mesothoracic leg. Why is called as pollen brush? Because the hairy structure present on these two legs, and they can help to cleaning the other bees and beehive. Cleaner's bee clean forager bee using pollen brush. Also remove dead and waste material from hive. 1 to 2 day old worker bee perform these work. The second indoor worker bee is nurse bee. Nurse bee take care of brood, feed the queen, drone and worker. Nurse bee having a specialized gland called hypopharyngeal gland, which is secrete royal jelly. Nurse bee feed royal jelly to the queen and 1 to 3 day old larva. Also feed bee bread to the drone. It take care of brood, and 3 to 11 days old worker bee perform this job. Then the builder bee. Builder bee build the hive. Builder bee having a specialized gland called wax gland situated on a ventral side of the abdomen. See here, wax gland situated on ventral side of abdomen of honeybee. Builder bee secrete wax from wax gland and chewing this wax and build the comb. 12 to 17 days old worker bee perform this work. Next indoor workers is guard bee. Guard bee also called as soldier bee or scout bee. The function is guard bee to defend the colony from enemies with the help of sting. Guard bee having a specialized apparatus called sting apparatus present on the tip of the abdomen. The main role of guard bee to protect the beehive from enemies. Extreme condition, guard bee sting and sacrifice their life. Sting apparatus cut from body of guard bee, that's why they will die or they sacrifice. Then the next indoor worker is fanner bee. Fanner bee beating their wings to cool down their hive when the temperature is rise. This behavior also help to evaporate water off the nectar store and reduce the water content in the nectar to safely store it as honey. Then the next indoor worker is receiver bee. Receiver bee also called as storekeeper. They receive the nectar and pollen from forager bee and make honey and store. The receiver bee evaporate nectar in their proboscis to vigorously shaking and produce honey. Some enzyme like invertase mix with nectar, and these invertase catalyze the hydrolysis of sucrose into the fructose and glucose. The main component of nectar is sucrose, and they convert into honey, or we call as fructose and glucose. 12 to 18 days old worker bee perform this job. The specific activities are defined by the age of the bee. For example, the first to 2 day old bee perform the cleaning activity. 3 to 5 day old worker bee perform the feeding of older larva. 6 to 11 days old worker bee perform the feeding of youngest larva. 12 to 17 days old worker bee produce wax and build the comb. 18 to 21 days old worker bee protect the entire hive. And 22 day onward they work as forager bee and searcher bee, or they perform outdoor duties. Thank you.